My great people. Today we're going to talk about three dividend stocks for retirement, the three best dividend stocks for retirement. I want you to watch this to the end because dividends are your friend, okay? And what I mean by that is, let me give you a definition. If you don't know what dividend stocks are, you're about to be blown away, okay? Most of you guys on my channel, you only invest into cryptocurrency, and I understand that. But I'm going to encourage you to explore into a few other ways of investing. You want to be diversified just so you don't have all your eggs in one basket. When all these crashes happen and stuff, a lot of you guys panic sell and be jumping ship, and that's because you're not diversified, okay? So a dividend is a distribution of profits by a corporation to its shareholders. When a corporation earns a profit or surplus, it is able to pay a proportion of the profit as a dividend to shareholders. Any amount not distributed is taken to be reinvested into the business. So basically, let's say you invested $1,000. I'm just giving you an example. You want to invest more than that. But let's say you invested $1,000, okay? Over time, as the company earns, it will send you back dividends. It will send the people that invested back money from the earnings. So it's not going based off of how well the company is doing in the stock market or any of that extra stuff, the popularity and all of that. It could be the worst company in the world, but as long as that company is profitable and maintaining its earnings, it can send you back money, okay? So you might make $50 in 3 months off of your investment or something on autopilot complete, you know, hands off and everything like that. And that's just being good. Okay. So I'm going to show you a couple more things. Let me see. So we're going to get into the three best dividends. Keep watching. All right. So a retirement portfolio should be based on a foundation of strong stocks and fixed income assets across a variety of industries. But one of the most important aspects, guys, of a great retirement stock is that it pays a dividend. All right, because you want guaranteed money. A lot of people in the investment realm only make money when they either trade or sell, okay? You don't want to have to trade or sell if it's actually a good stock. You want something to kick back as well, okay? All right, so let's keep it going. Okay, because those payments will help your portfolio thrive during periods of market turbulence. For instance, we had a lot of crashes over the past couple of weeks with cryptocurrency, with Bitcoin, Ethereum, Emacs, even AMP Crypto, one of my favorite cryptocurrencies and everything. We've been experiencing a lot of dips in that market, okay? But if you had dividend portfolio, meaning you had earnings coming in from investing into dividends, let's say it's McDonald's and you invested a couple hundred thousand or something like that. You might be at like $5,000 a month, depending on when you invested into McDonald's, like maybe probably back then or something. Pretty sure right now you have to invest way more than that. But let's say you got a loan for that. In the description of this video, we have funding for things like this where you don't have to risk your own money. So go ahead and go to the link in the description of the video, you know, after this video. But anyway, you know, back in the day, if you had to put in a couple hundred thousand into it, you know, McDonald's back in the earlier days, you probably would be at maybe $4,000 to $5,000 per month. You don't even have to like touch anything, or it doesn't matter where the stock market is. As long as it's in business and it's profitable, the shareholders will be getting their cut every year. Okay. So in order to help you find stocks that will help you breeze through retirement financially, three Motley Fool contributors are recommending three dividend paying stocks that can be solid additions to your retirement portfolio. So if you're about to retire and you're looking for something to put your money in that's going to be safe besides a damn bank, okay, like, because that's not safe, you want to invest into companies that will pay you back a dividend. But these need to be long-standing companies that are proven and everything, that aren't going anywhere, that's been passing their company down through generations, okay? A powerful payer for your portfolio, Eric Volkman, Consolidated Edison. One of the sturdiest dividend stocks on the scene is Consolidated Edison. One of the sturdiest dividend stocks on the scene is Consolidated Edison, the longstanding utility that supplies power and natural gas to New York City. Okay, so now this is what I'm talking about as far as longstanding, what I'm talking about as far as passing the company down from generation to generation. This is a very safe investment. Hey, disclaimer, I'm not a financial advisor, but I can advise you to become financially free by taking the information in the description of this video, but I can't tell you to invest into any of these stocks. Disclaimer, lawyer fees, stuff like that. But anyway, this is a power and natural gas. So that will only play out once Elon Musk figures out how to use some type of different energy sources, okay? So my point is this will be around for a long time. Okay, so dividend raises from Con Ed, as New Yorkers like to call it, are so reliable. The company is a dividend aristocrat, one of only a clutch of S&P 500 index stocks that have lifted their payouts at least once annually for a minimum of 25 years in a row. So sometimes payouts get skipped, like sometimes you can get paid quarterly, you can get paid annually. Then other times, like a company, depending on what's going on with them, you know, you might get skipped a couple of times or something. But this is the only one, one of the only ones that has been paid out 25 years in a row, guys. All right, so in fact, before long, Con Ed will join an even more exclusive club that the Dividend Kings. These are the companies that have done the once per year minimum raise for at least 50 years. Just now, the company's streak stands at 47, okay? So we're gonna hop down and I'm gonna show you the second one. Once bitten, twice shy, can create a great opportunity. Chuck Salita, Kinder Morgan. Energy pipeline giant Kinder Morgan currently offers investors a nearly 6% yield, okay? That is pretty high, okay? It's not pretty high, but it's decent. Okay, even better, it offers that yield after completing a massive transformation that started when it was forced to cut its dividend in late 2015 to protect its balance sheet. That's important to understand because it means that Kinder Morgan today is a much stronger company than it was prior to the dividend cut. So it's getting stronger and stronger. It's getting stronger and stronger. Today's dividend is much more sustainable. And while its dividend growth rate has recently dropped below expectations, its cash flow and thus dividend coverage remains strong. With natural gas and oil usage protected to remain steady and increase over the next several decades, it's likely that its pipelines will remain in demand for a long time to come. So a prediction like that, when you're looking for an investment, can give you confidence. That's why I'm talking about. Take your time, guys. Like a lot of you guys have your money and you like, it's like hot potato. I need to put my money somewhere. I need to throw it in something. And then when you experience a massive loss, you wonder why it happened. You have to take your time with investments. Yes, you don't want to be last to the game, but it doesn't hurt you if you're not the very first to the game just because you wanted to do market research, okay? So stay safe out here. Anyway, all right, so we're going to jump down to the third one. The best dividend stock not currently paying a dividend. What? Okay, so Barbara Eisner Bayer, Walt Disney. I'm going to go out on a limb by recommending a dividend stock that's not currently paying a dividend, but its strong growth prospects in history and stability trumps that fact. When you were little, you probably were in love with Walt Disney. Pretty sure all of you were. Mickey Mouse, all of them. And his universal characters, films, and TV shows. And if you're a parent or grandparent, your children and grandchildren probably are in love with them too. You may not love Mickey Mouse in particular, but there must be some cartoon character or superhero who you adore and is brought to life under Disney's monstrous ecosystem. So basically what they're saying is Disney has infiltrated the lives of people in the past few generations so strongly that we know that Disney is not going anywhere. Like it would take an act of God literally before, you know, Disney would go somewhere. So they're saying if you're going to invest into a dividend stock that doesn't pay a dividend, but is more of a growth, stock, then Disney would be one of the safest ones. So yes, Disney suffered immensely during the pandemic as it had to close down its theme parks and cruise ships. Fiscal year 2020 showed the worst results ever, and yet the stock roared 73.7% higher from April 2020 to April 2021. In fact, before the pandemic hit in 2019, more than 179 million people visited Disney parks worldwide. So we all know that it's opening, you know, everything is reopening now. So like, you don't even have to consider what happened, you know, during the pandemic when it goes to investing, you know, and I'm pretty sure next time something like this happens, based off of what they learned, they'll be prepared to, like, you know, keep things going. Okay. So those were the three best dividend stocks for retirement. If you're new to the channel, I want you to do a gently sidekick to the subscription button. And when a like, when that bell pops up, you know, that's not the dinner bell. That's not the school is out bell. That's letting you know that when you see a thumbnail from me, you want to click on that mug and come back, because we will miss you if you don't. Okay. Love you guys. See you on the next one.